Hi, this is Alex from MinuteEarth. Back in the early 2000s, lots of people couldn't have imagined life without alarm clocks, CD players, calendars, cameras, or lots of other devices. But along came the iPhone and other smartphones, and they took over the functions of dozens of things we used to think were essential. The smartphone story could even be a model for fighting climate change. Not because smartphones use a fraction of the energy of all the things they replace, although they do, but because they represent a different approach to design in general. And that approach is to focus on function rather than form. That requires focusing on understanding the underlying problem, and then engineering a wide spectrum of potential solutions. This approach could revolutionize how we think about energy efficiency. Traditionally, improvements in energy efficiency have mostly focused on individual devices, which can be quite fruitful. But focusing on individual devices is kind of like if Apple had spent effort inventing a better alarm clock, a better CD player, a better calendar, and a better camera. With an iPhone, we don't need the standalone devices at all, because it can function as all of them. So when it comes to using energy efficiently, rather than just installing a more efficient furnace, some people have focused instead on the desired function, staying warm. They designed and insulated their house so well that they could get rid of their furnace altogether, letting them heat their house with 99% less energy. In the same vein, rather than just making cars more efficient, what if we focus on the desired function, getting where we want, when we want, and create an efficient transportation system where we can drive less or get rid of our personal cars entirely? The most efficient car or furnace is no car or no furnace, while still being able to get around and stay warm. In other words, it's not thinking efficient, it's thinking different. This video was sponsored by the University of Minnesota, where students, faculty, and staff across all fields of study are working to solve the grand challenges facing society. One of these challenges is assuring clean water and sustainable ecosystems, which includes figuring out how to use energy in a way that doesn't contribute to climate change. At the Humphrey School of Public Affairs, Professor Gabe Chan studies innovation in energy systems and how to make policies that accelerate that innovation. And at the law school, Professor Alexandra Klass investigates the legal and regulatory challenges surrounding energy use and energy transportation. Thanks, University of Minnesota.